welcome to another edition of Ready, Steady, Go, and it really is a star-packed edition tonight. First of the star names to come out is that of a girl who's making her first appearance as a commère, and as you know, a commère is a mother of a compère. Here's Dusty Springfield.
Old solo talking Springfield. That's going to be a bit strange asking the questions instead of being asked. But let's put you out of your misery straight away and introduce a fabulous version of Twist and Shout by, what was their name again? The Beatles! George, how did you feel when you were in a plane and the door flew open?
Cold.
You ought to wipe the comic cuts, you know. Oh, this is Ringo. This is no good. George, how many guitars do you actually use?
How many? Well, one at a time.
You only use one.
But I've got about...
How many have you got?
Four.
Four?
Yeah.
They all look so beautiful as that. Ah, listen to those.
I got this the other day.
Yeah.
This is
about,
the new one.
This is the new one?
Yeah.
It's very expensive.
It's not.
No?
No.
I won't ask you how much it is. How about this hair now? Is it real or is it a wig?
It's a real wig.
It's a real wig. Is it plastic or is it... I mean, it's
fiberglass.
Real fiberglass. Okay, that's okay. George, over to Keith.
And there you saw the hitchhiker. Thank you, Teresa. And Pat, our next guest star is someone you've probably already seen on television this week singing some of the songs that she made famous. She just got a new record out and we wanted you, our Ready Steady Go audience, to be the first to hear it. So here is Helen Shapiro.
But I
Beatle time again. Hello, Ringo.
Hello.
Lots of cards as usual, especially about the rings on your fingers. He says, "Dear Ringo, why do you have all those rings on your fingers? Do they represent anything?"
No, I wear them on my fingers because I can't put them through my nose. None of room.
Let's have a look at them. You've got four on here, but how many do you actually have?
649 and a half.
You've counted them recently, obviously. Here's a great one. I've never seen a close-up of the Beatles from the knees down.
Very lucky.
So please, could we have one on the show, and what size shoes do they take? I mean, what size shoes do you take?
Seven.
What about Paul?
Eight and a half.
And George?
Seven and a half.
What about John?
42.
Oh, yeah. Ringo, why do you dislike Donald Duck?
You know, you can't understand it.
Say that again. I think it's a good enough reason, don't you? Yeah. Could you tell me, or this is the girl, would you tell her what you and Paul have got written on your bracelets?
Here it is. On one side it's got Richie, because my real name's Richard, don't tell anybody.
Yeah.
And on the other side it's Richard. Got 21st birthday, love, Mum.
Love.
Good old mother.
Good old mother, that's very nice. That's really good. Bye-bye, Ringo.
Thanks a lot. Now it's mime time. We've got four girls picked out an audition earlier in the week who are going to mime to a Brenda Lee disc. And we have a judge to pick out the best of the four when they've done it. The judge being Mr. Paul McCartney.
Good evening.
You're keen on budding Brenda Lee's, are you?
Oh, yes.
I'll bet you are, yes. Right. Well, let's introduce the four contestants to you. They are, from left to right, Judy Johnson. Hello, Judy. June Dartnell. Hi, June. Hello, Kathleen Sullivan. Hi there. And hello to Melanie Coe. Right, they're all set to go, I hope, are you? Ready, Paul? Okay, off we go with Let's Jump the Broomstick.
Well, come a little baby, let's jump the broomstick. Come a let's tie a knot. Come a little baby, let's jump the broomstick. Come a let's tie a knot. Father don't like it, a brother don't like it, a sister don't like it, a mother don't like it. Come a little baby, let's jump the broomstick. Come a let's tie a knot. Go on to Alabama, back from Texarkana. I'm a bat from Texarkana. Going all around the world. A father don't like it. A brother don't like it. A sister don't like it. A mother don't like it. Come a little baby, let's jump the broomstick. Come a let's tie a knot. A couple little baby, don't I mean a maybe. Let's settle down. A couple little baby, don't I mean a maybe.
Performance from four would be Brenda Lee as well. I wonder if our panel of judges has made up its mind and is unanimous.
Oh, yes, it has.
It is. It has. Paul, who's it going to be?
I think the winner, as far as I'm concerned, number four.
Number four, Melanie Coe. Here's the prize, Melanie, the LP from Paul. And all our congratulations. Very well done. Thank you.
Hello, gorgeous Paul. I've got some questions to ask you here. It says, please, could you tell me the name of your racing greyhound?
I haven't got one, actually.
You haven't?
No, it's a... Well, a girl sent in a letter to me, and she said, would you like a racing greyhound?
A racing.
And I said, yeah. But she hasn't sent it yet.
She hasn't? Oh. How did she send it to you? I'm sure she
will. No, she hasn't sent it yet. I hope she does, though. You know.
Oh, it's a great like one. Listen. Is it true you sleep with your eyes open?
Well, you know, I haven't seen myself do, but actually the fellas say that I do.
They do? Well,
they've sort of seen me sleeping with my eyes open. I haven't
they really
seen
have.
Joking.
How can you do that?
I don't know, you know, it's just sort of half
open. You're just clever. Just brilliant, Paul. Yeah. Please ask Paul if he plucks his well-shaped eyebrows. I think he... Do you?
No.
You know, and it doesn't look so... No, they're perfectly natural girls. They're absolutely beautiful. Paul, do you mind girls screaming all through your act?
No, we like them screaming, generally, all of us, but it's a bit much all the way through.
Yeah.
But we love them screaming.
Here.
So, you know, I'll be some screaming now, so what's your next number going to be?
I'll get you.
You will? This is a question which you've probably been asked 1,000 times before, but you always, all of you give different versions or different answers. So you've got to tell me now, how did the Beatles get their name?
I just thought of it.
You just thought of it? Another brilliant Beatles.
No, really.
Were they called anything else before?
They called the Quarrymen.
Oh, you rugged character. Oh, John, listen. Do you have false teeth, as they always look so evil? Even?
No. Even? They're all chipped and battered.
No, girls, would you say his teeth were chipped and battered?
No.
No!
They're rather beautiful.
No, they're real.
Lovely teeth.
Is it true that when you were a kid, you were shot at for stealing apples?
Yes.
Is that what these beautiful marks
no,
are?
No, they're scabbed.
They're scabbed. Well, let's have a look. Show them your scabs. There's nothing there at all, because he's got a beautiful complexion.
Let me see your scabs. Hey.
Oh, sorry. I think this is where we better start finishing. What are you going to sing next?
She loves you.
Of course. She does?
She loves you, and you know you should be glad. Ooh, she loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you.
Last week we promised to send LPs to the senders of the three best questions for the Beatles. We'd like to send the top prize to the sender of this outfit, but in fact we haven't got a name and address to go with it, which is a pity, because it's a terrific effort. Rank, Ringo, could you hold the other end? Mate, thank you. It says Beatles across the top, and then it says John and Paul and George and Ringo, and every card has got a different question on it, which I think is a terrific effort, don't you? However, we have got the name of Jennifer Fortnum of Eggemswood Road, Beaconsfield. Who would like to know? Could you tell me what the Beatles would prefer to do, have a night out with Bridget Bardot or £1,000? Paul?
A night out with Bridget Bardot.
John?
£1,000.
Ringo?
Bridget.
George?
Both, please.
Both? I'm not surprised. You got the right idea. You could teach these other guys something. Another question. He's older than you. From Celia Johnson of Stanley Avenue, Wembley. Could you ask the Beatles their views on dialectic materialism? Paul?
What?
Ringo?
What's that?
George?
Yes, I enjoy it.
You enjoy it. John?
Well, I've been thinking about this one. The 19th century political theories, Marx and Hegel, involved a theory that the head-on clash conflicting ideological produced a state of temporary equilibrium until threatened by the next stage in political thought. Mm. In my opinion, the ultimate validity still has to be tested.
Yeah. Right, that's about all we've time for at the moment. This press conference is obviously going to go on with lots more questions. Next week, same time, do be with us, please, for another Ready, Steady, Go. Until then, so long.